My dears, welcome to my class. Today's class is the adjective. The adjective, the concept has already been started. It is in progress. Okay, let me continue and just to teach you what is called. Once again, I'm not going to teach you the definition. Adjective is a word which adds something to the meaning of either a noun or a pronoun. Noun gurinchi gaani, pronoun gurinchi gaani, edo kontha vishayam cheppadane manam adjective one. But adjective one is a good boy, good, is a kind person, kind, it is a big house, big, like that. These are the words which give additional information regarding the subjects concerned, that is either noun or pronoun. Okay, come to the next point. Here, classification of adjectives, because we have to classify the adjectives very clearly, then only we'll have a better idea of the concept concerned. మనకి దాని గురించి పూర్తి వరకు తెలియాలంటే దాన్ని విడదీయాలి. విడదీసుకుని ఒక్కో టాపిక్ తెలుసుకోవడం ద్వారా ఇట్ విల్ బీ వెరీ ఈజీ టు లెర్న్, ఇట్ విల్ బి మోర్ యూస్ఫుల్ టు అస్. బికాస్ కాంపిటేటివ్ ఎగ్జామినేషన్స్ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ వ్యూలో, అన్నింటి పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ వ్యూలో, డాక్టర్ స్కిల్స్ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ వ్యూలో, అన్నింటి విషయాల్లో కూడా ద కన్స్ట్రక్టివ్ ఇంగ్లీష్, కన్స్ట్రక్టివ్ అప్రోచ్ ఈజ్ నీడెడ్. దట్ ఈస్ ఓన్లీ ది రీజన్ వై ఐఎమ్ ఇన్సిస్టింగ్ ఈచ్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీ పాయింట్. అఫ్ కోర్స్ నాకు 10 వీడియోలు ఎక్కువ అవ్వచ్చు, దట్స్ మ్యాటర్ ఆఫ్ మెటీరియల్. ఓకే షవి, హియర్ దిస్ ఈస్ ఫస్ట్ వన్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ప్రాపర్ యాడ్జెక్టివ్స్. ప్రాపర్ యాడ్జెక్టివ్స్ ఆర్ ది యాడ్జెక్టివ్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ డిరైవ్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ జియోగ్రఫికల్ ప్లేసెస్ లైక్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఇండియా, అమెరికా, చైనా, లైక్ దట్. దీస్ ఆర్ ది ప్లేసెస్, ది నేమ్స్ ఆఫ్ కంట్రీస్ ఫ్రమ్ విచ్ వీ కెన్ డిరైవ్ adjectives. For example, I am an Indian, I am Indian, there it is noun. I like Indian culture, there it is an adjective, isn't it? He leaves America, America is a noun. He likes American goods, there it is an adjective. Understood? She, those are Chinese. This is, the children like Chinese toys. We follow Japanese technology. Like that, these are the adjectives which are derived from proper nouns. That's why those are called proper adjectives. I think you might have understood. The next one is called descriptive adjective. Description continuity, chapadam. Some information, we are going to describe a person, a place, or a thing. For example, he is a kind person. Kind tells the quality of the person. Is it not? Like that, it is a big house. Big tells the size of the house. Like that. Next, quantitative adjectives, which tells the quantity. I want to summarize. There is little water. Like that, these are the words which are used to express the quantitative adjectives. And whereas, demonstrative adjectives. What we call demonstrative? Show something and say something. These books are mine. That is my house. That is pronoun. That house is mine. That is adjective. That is my house. That is a pronoun. That house is mine. There it is adjective. See, these are mangoes. These pronoun. These mangoes are sour. These mangoes. Like that, whenever you want to stress a particular thing, a particular place, that is said to be demonstrative. Ante chapadam. This is a car. This demonstrative pronoun. This car is mine. There this is demonstrative adjective. Like that, these are the concepts which have already been taught you. Now I am going to teach you numerical adjectives. The numerical adjectives are classified into three subclasses. What are they? Definite numerical adjective, indefinite numerical adjective, and distributive numerical adjective. Like that, these are the three adjectives which are derived from numeral adjectives. Now, these numeral adjectives are defined definite numeral adjectives. These definite numeral adjectives are further classified into two kinds of adjectives, which we call cardinal numbers and ordinal numbers. Cardinal numbers are nothing but natural numbers only. I want 5 rupees. I have 3 brothers. Like that. Number, a number cheptam. A number chepte, that is what is called a cardinal number. He pays 100 rupees. 100 rupees. 100. My hand has 5 fingers. 5. This is what is called cardinal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. The second one is called ordinal numbers. Ordinal numbers are those numbers which tell the order of ranking. For example, my brother got first rank. That is the order. Indira Gandhi is the first woman Prime Minister of India. First. Today is 25th March. 25th March. 25th. Don't say 25. 25th. This is what is called the concept ordinal numbers, which tells the order. I think many of you understood it. Next one is indefinite numeral adjectives. Indefinite. Some are there. We don't know how many are. Some people. Some books. Is it not? Here, enough books. No, in pictures in a particular book. Like that, we are going to know. This means all, some, enough, no, many, few, several. These are the words which are used to express the indefinite numerical adjectives. For example, here are some ripe mangoes. Some means how many? No, there is no definiteness of the number. That's why these are called indefinite numeral adjectives. But one more important. Here some is used. In quantitative adjectives also some used. I want some rice. There some. Here also some. Sir, what is the difference between these things? But here these are used for plurals. There are some books. There is some rice. Okay, we need not have that much knowledge. For example, should we have it? Because it may be 10 or 15 videos. Okay, no. Next, one more important. There are several mistakes in your answers. Several mistakes in your answers. Several people presented. Like this, we are going to know. There are no pictures in this book. There are no pictures. No is said to be indefinite numerical adjective. There is, no room. Room means place. There it is, what is called quantitative adjective. So, there is no sugar. There is no sugar. But, there are no pictures. No is used here. No is also used here. What is the difference between these? Here, this is what is called in quantitative adjectives. There is no rice, that is that cannot be counted, uncountable nouns. But here no is used. But here there are no books. No. But here the no is followed by a plural noun. That is only the difference what you have to find out. That's why these do come under the heading called indefinite numerical adjectives. అదేనమ్మా మీకు అంటే ఇక్కడ కొన్ని సింగులర్స్గా కొన్ని మాత్రమే వాడాలి, వాటికి ప్లూరల్ సెన్స్ ఉండదు. దోస్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ వాట్ వీ కాల్ మెటీరియల్ నౌన్. మెటీరియల్ నౌన్ సుగర్, రైస్, పేపర్. దీస్ ఆర్ ది థింగ్స్ విచ్ కెనాట్ బి కౌంటెడ్ అన్లెస్ వీ టేక్ సమ్ మెజరింగ్ యూనిట్స్. బట్ హియర్ దీస్ ఆర్ థింగ్స్ విచ్ కెన్ బి కౌంటెడ్. దట్ ఈస్ ఓన్లీ ది రీజన్ దీస్ కెన్ బి కౌంటెడ్. దట్ ఈస్ ఓన్లీ ది రీజన్ న్యూమరల్ ఎగ్జిక్యూటివ్స్ ఆర్ is the name to them. Next, here this is the way in which here there are enough books. Here there are many students. There are few vacancies. There are several mistakes like that. Whatever can be counted, those do come under the heading called numeral adjectives, because there is no definiteness in the numerology. What is it called? Numbers. That's why these are called indefinite numeral adjectives. Okay. Next one is distributive numeral adjectives. Distributive means repertoire. Each boy is given a prize. Means every boy is given a prize. Understood? Each student is given an identity card. Each student means every student. That's why this is a what is called distributed. The word is common, which is applicable to all. Next, every student. Yeah, every student is happy. Yeah, all students are happy. The word every is used. Yeah, this either is used only for those things which have only two choices. Suppose manke there are two roads on road. This road leads to bus station, this road also leads to bus station. So either road leads to the bus station. That means to say both roads are found fit for leading you or somebody to the bus station. They either in word I am annatlayite akkada rendu options e undali. Ee uncountable anamata. Neither of your answers is correct. And ye okati correct kaadu. And it means all are wrong. But means only deemed and each, every, neither, these are used more than two or any number. But if you want to make use of the adjective, that is either, we have to go for only two things, two persons, two places. Anything you have to take only two. Suppose you have given two answers. Both are right. Either answer is right. If you have given two answers are wrong. Either answer is wrong. That is the way in which we can make use of the adjective which we call either. So some of the examples which I am going to tell you here is that each boy must take his turn. Not every boy. Next, either player deserves to win. Here, either means there are two players who compete each other. In such cases, we have to go for either player deserves. That means to say, every student must wear a mask. Every means all. Next, neither statement is true. There are so many statements which are given by somebody. All are fake. All are not true. In such cases, what we have to do is that neither statement is true. Next, the remaining part of the adjectives is to be taught in the following class. నేర్చుకున్న తర్వాత క్లారిటీగా అండ్ క్లియర్గా నేర్చుకున్నట్లయితే మనకు యూజ్ ఉంటుంది. ఒక హార్డ్లీ 10 మినిట్స్ కష్టపడినట్లయితే డైలీ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఈస్ లేడ్ ఐ మీన్ పర్ఫెక్ట్లీ అండ్ యూ కెన్ రీప్ ఇట్స్ బెనిఫిట్స్. ఐ హోప్ యూ మేడ్ హ్యావ్ అండర్స్టూడ్. థ్యాంక్ యూ. ఇఫ్ యూఆర్ ఇంట్రెస్టెడ్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ మై ఛానల్.